Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Nidhi and I am your English coach. This is our 21-day spoken English challenge and today is day 1 of this course. This entire course has been designed with the aim of people getting comfortable with English language and to improve their communication skills. Each lesson will have parts, certain techniques, tips and tricks that you definitely have to follow. Do you accept this challenge and interested in joining us in this journey? Do let me know that by commenting challenge accepted in the comment section below. Now let's start with day 1. Most of us get nervous when we talk to people in public place, and the level of tension escalates when we talk to strangers because that time we need to speak in a formal condition. Also, they say that the first impression becomes the last impression, and that is something which makes us even more conscious. How to start a conversation, how to create an impact on someone, proper use of grammar, correct accent, pronunciation, and the list goes on. In today's video, we learn how to have a good and decent conversation with someone in first meeting and to last a good impression on different people around us. Today's lesson is divided into 2 parts. In part 1, we'll talk about some different ideas like how to start a conversation, difference between formal and informal conversation. And in part 2, we'll have a look at those points that you should avoid talking about on your first meeting. So let's get started. How to start a conversation? To start a conversation, the very first and important thing is to know how to greet people. So the first thing we do when we meet people is to greet them. Greetings are formal expressions of goodwill. We address people with expressions of kind wishes when we meet them. So the expressions like hey, hi, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. These are the expressions we can use to greet people. These type of expressions are available in all languages and of course in English too. You may anytime greet anybody with hi or hello, but to say morning, afternoon, evening and night, you would have to use these expressions in particular time slot. So let's look into this chart. This is a 24-hour time slot which will help you in understanding the correct time to use all these expressions. Between 6 a.m. in the morning to 11:59 a.m., you may greet anybody with good morning. While meeting, you may wish them good morning, and while leaving, just simply say goodbye. Now from 12 p.m. to 5 p.m., you may greet anybody with good afternoon. While meeting them, wish them good afternoon, and while leaving, just wish them goodbye. Now to use the word good evening, the perfect timing is 5 p.m. to 7:59 p.m. This is the time when we wish somebody good evening and we can say goodbye at the time of leaving. 8 o'clock is generally a perfect time for sleep, and that's why 8 p.m. to 5:59 a.m. in the morning, we use good night as a greeting. But the area of focus here is that good night is a farewell wish. That means when you would meet somebody, you would say good evening, and when you would say bye to them, that time you can use good night. So good night is never used in the starting of the conversation, or when you are meeting somebody, do not start your conversation with good night. Right? You would start it with good evening, and while departure, you can say good night. This is how you may greet people with these 4 general greetings in your first conversation. And now, what after that? So let's continue the conversation. In English language, we categorize any conversation in 2 ways: formal conversation and informal conversation. There are different expressions to use in both different situations. You have to be very careful for using these expressions. Formal conversation is used when you are talking to anybody for the very first time, or talking to your boss or maybe your colleague. In other words, people whom you are not that friendly with. Informal conversation, on the other hand, can be done with the people of our own family or friends or relatives and with whom we share the same wavelength. As I said, there are different expressions to use at different situations. In our class, we'll see the expressions in both conversations, formal conversation and informal conversation. When you are meeting with your friends or family, you would start the conversation like this. Hi, I'm Nora. Or, hey, hi, what's up? And when you are in a formal situation, maybe your office meeting where you are meeting so many new people, you would say, hello, my name is Nora. Or, hello, how are you? Saying, I am Nora is a very informal way of introducing yourself, and saying, my name is Nora is a formal way. So even if you're going for your interviews, use the second phrase for your introduction. Hello, my name is Nora. Did you see the difference in the expressions in both the conversation? When I ask what's up, I'm just trying to ask my friend what is going in his life. So this is a very informal way to ask somebody how they are and what's happening in their life. But when I'm in a formal gathering, I can't ask any random person what's happening in their life. So I would stick to my formal question, how are you? Now as a reply, you may hear something like this. Hey, nothing much, just enjoying my holidays. And what are you up to nowadays? Here, the other person wants to know, what are you doing nowadays? The meaning of the phrase, what are you up to, is what are you doing nowadays, or what is that keeping you busy these days? So you may come up with such answers, I'm preparing for my exams, or just taking guitar classes, or nothing much, just getting bored. And in the formal conversation, you may get a reply as, I'm fine, thank you, how are you? And you would say, I'm fine too, thanks. It's always better to keep your formal conversation short and meaningful. There are many ways to continue the conversation. For example, if you haven't met a friend in recent days, you may use the phrase, long time, no see, or where have you been these days? The expression long time no see shows that you missed your friend and you want to know where have they been these days. The other person may revert as, yeah, it's been so long. Actually, I've been busy with my studies. And in formal condition, you would continue the conversation by saying, I'm glad to see you or nice to meet you. And the other person may revert as, nice to meet you too. Or glad to meet you too. Once the introduction is done, there can be seen an awkward silence between two people. That's the time when they don't know how to continue the conversation which they started. Let's see how to overcome this situation. There are a number of questions that you can ask to have an interactive session. For example, you can talk about their location, where do they live, their qualifications, if they are into any job or not. Then if you get comfortable with the person and they also show interest in talking to you, you may even talk about your personal things, as in what their hobbies and interests are. Now let's frame some questions and their answers on each point. So you may ask, where are you from? Or where do you live? I'm from Delhi. I live in Delhi. What are your qualifications? I have a degree in engineering. I'm a final year student of arts. Now you may talk about their job. What do you do for a living? Or where do you work? Or where are you currently working? I am a digital marketer. Or I am a teacher. Let's talk about the hobbies now. What do you do in your free time? Well, I like reading books. Or I like dancing. See? Isn't it easy to have a decent and interactive conversation with someone? It is said that if you give a good start to a conversation, half of the battle is already won. It actually boosts your confidence and you get more energy to talk further. Now in the second part of this video, we are going to talk about some topics that you should avoid talking about on first meeting. Let's look into them one by one. Anything negative. Don't ever talk about any negative thing in your first meeting. Never share your complaints or if you have issues about someone or something, or you hate your boss or you don't like visiting any place, please don't talk about these things in your first meeting. Because the other person is more interested in knowing your positive sides. So always talk about the positive things that are happening in your life and keep those negative things aside for some time. Second is anything about your physical appearance. Don't talk about someone's appearance, like how do they look like, what's their height, what's their weight, what's the color of the skin, as you'll never be appreciated for these kind of talks. Third, do not talk about the age factor. Never ask people about their age. This may sound very rude and offensive for them. So avoid asking for each of your age in your first conversation. Number 4. Anything that makes you seem self-centered. If you're someone who talks about yourself a lot and not at all have patience for listening to others, hold on. This tip is for you. No one actually admires it when a person dominates the conversation or talks too much about him or herself, especially when you meet someone first time. To avoid an eye-centric conversation, you should show interest in others by asking questions related to their life, job, career plans, and of course, there is a lot to talk about. So sometimes being a passive listener also creates a positive impact. So yeah, keep these things in your mind and you're good to go. That is enough for today's class. Today we learned how to start a conversation with a stranger or how to start a conversation with your friends and family members. In our next lesson, we'll get to know about those important and interesting English phrases that a beginner should never miss. Some phrases that you really need to cram to be a fluent English speaker. So, don't miss out on that lesson. Alright guys, now is the time for your homework. Now, I want you all to write a dialogue series between two people. So, our two characters are Cheryl and Peter. Your task is to write an imaginary dialogue conversation between both of them. How do they start a conversation and how do they continue the conversation by asking different questions? I think it's quite enough for day one session. You guys already have your homework with you. Please do that and don't forget to join me for day two session in this 21 days spoken English challenge. Bye.